Okay, I was born in Honolulu, Hawaii, and my folks brought me to California when I was a baby. I went to school in San Francisco and then a private school in Palo Alto. Both my mother and father were artists. My mother did a lot of fashion drawings, sometimes for papers. Through Blanding, I had exhibitions in group shows when I was 9, 10 years old, doing etchings and block prints, and I had some shows in the department store of the city of Paris in San Francisco, and I gave a demonstration of printing etchings when I was, I think, 9 or 10 in the Legion of Honor. My mother died when I was about 10 years old, and I had become such good friends as a child with Blanding and Mildred Sloan, well-known artists and a puppeteer in San Francisco. So Blanding had taught me how to do etchings and block prints and string puppets. So I got an early start. I went to high school, Fairfax High School, and got a job as a puppeteer in a puppet movie, a puppet short. It was a takeoff on the Marx Brothers, King Kong, and Mae West. Blanding had was commissioned to do the lighting for a pageant at the Texas Centennial, which was a 100th anniversary of Texas. The important thing of that event in my life was that was where I met my wife, Glenn. She was also in the cast. I went to Honolulu, spent a year there. I did some work on mostly on Pinocchio, a little bit on Bambi, and a little bit on Fantasia. So I never did catch up with the main studio because about that time I got struck down with polio.
Very fine tuba. Do you know it, Tubby?
And I quit my job, and I think we had $1,500 or $1,600 in the bank, and we spent it all on a Cine Special 16mm camera to go on our own to do educational films. We did three live-action medical films. Blanding Sloan, who I talked about before, and I organized what we called East West Studio to do this film called The Way of Peace. It was premiered in Constitution Hall in Washington, D.C. in 1945. 47.
Sailing over a cardboard sea, but it wouldn't be made believe if you believed in me. canvas sky, hanging over a muslin tree. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Without your love, it's a honky-tonk parade. Without your love, it's a melody played in a penny arcade. It's the Barnum and Bailey world, just as phony as it can be. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me.
There's only a paper moon sailing over the cardboard sea. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me.
True, 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 true.
Yes, it's only a canvas sky, hanging over a muslin tree. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Without your
Gene and I had done some stage sets for a musical production called Magdalena. The costume designer for that was Irene Sheroff, and she remembered what I had done on that and asked me to do the mass for the movie version of The King and I.
Beautiful little version of the time machine for the movie. It was made by Hua Chang.
I just used the blueprints that were supplied by the MGM, and we built the model from that. Small machine probably tops the $50. Was 800,000
and 750.
All right.
I'm the yawning man, the yawning man. I come when shadows creep. With my yawning song, I stroll along and help put people to sleep. If you just can't sleep and you're tired as could be, there's a remedy. It's the yawning melody. If you're yawn, yawn, then you sleep, sleep, sleep till the dawn, 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 so little yawn.
Thank you. repeat, there is nothing wrong with your television set. You are about to participate in a great adventure. You are about to experience the awe and mystery which reaches from the inner mind to the outer limits.
Gene and I did get together again and open up another studio called Excelsior. And we did mostly television commercials. We did commercials for Barbie doll, some Mattel toys. And about that time I thought that I'd had about enough of this and wanted to get away, and we moved here to Carmel.
Till another day, it still will be my lucky day.